Sister Ruby Shaw asked me to do a sermon, amen. And I knew that I had only a week in between the special service we're going to do next Sunday, and then in June, we're going to deal with a series of sermons for the men, amen.
So amen.
To Father's Day. So I knew the day that I could get this in today. I knew it was a holiday weekend. A lot of people would be missing. But we want to get it in because I think you will be blessed by it. We had an awesome service this morning at the 9 o'clock service. And
amen.
She asked me to do something on being offended. Amen. Being offended. And as a Christian, how do we deal with being offended? Amen. When we are offended, and we all get offended, amen.
Amen.
We all get offended, and how should we respond as Christians when someone offends us? In the book of, in the Old Testament, in the book of 1 Samuel 26, I would ask that you would join me in that text today, 1 Samuel 26, and beginning at verse number 7. And when you have found it, I would ask that you would stand as we honor the reading of God's word together. 1 Samuel, the 26th chapter, and beginning at verse number 7. Praise God. So David and Abishai went to the army by night, and there was Saul lying asleep inside the camp, with his spear stuck in the ground near his head. Abner and the soldiers were lying around him. Abishai said to David, "Today God has delivered your enemy into your hands. Now let me put him to the ground with one thrust of my spear, and I won't strike him twice." But David said to Abishai, "Don't destroy him. Who can lay a hand on the Lord's anointed and be guiltless? As surely as the Lord lives," he said, "the Lord himself will strike him. Either his time will come and he will die, or he will go into battle and perish. But the Lord forbid that I should lay a hand on the Lord's anointed. Now get the spear and water jar that are near his head, and let's go." So David took the spear and water jar near Saul's head, and they left. No one saw or knew about it, nor did anyone wake up. They were all asleep. They were all asleep because the Lord had put them into a deep sleep.
Amen.
May the Lord bless the reading and the hearing of his holy word. Amen.
Amen.
And I just want to teach this morning on this subject, when God allows me to be offended. Amen.
Amen.
I want you to look at your neighbor and say, "Neighbor,
amen.
When God allows
me
to be offended."
Amen.
I want you to look at another neighbor and say, "Neighbor,
amen.
When God allows me to be offended."
Amen.
Amen. When God allows me to be offended. One of the greatest struggles we face as Christians is dealing with people who offend us. Being saved and sanctified, reading our Bibles and attending church does not make it any easier to deal with people who offend us.
Amen.
Even as a pastor and being saved for 32 years does not make it any easier for me as the spiritual leader to deal with people who offend me. The greatest difficulty is that people can offend us in so many ways. Sometimes people offend us with their words, and it is what they say to us or say about us that offends us. Sometimes people offend us with their actions. It is what they do or what they don't do that brings us offense. Sometimes it's a person's attitude that offends us. They have an attitude that just rubs us the wrong way. And their attitude toward us offends us. And we are offended by their attitude toward us. It may be the way that they speak to us. It may be the way that they even look at us. And sometimes the way they speak to us or even look at us, they cause us to be offended. Sometimes it's how they roll their eyes at us that we are causing us to be offended by them. And in the midst of us being offended, the great challenge is to be a Christian and how to handle the offense in a godly way. Paul said, Celia, that when I seek to do good, the evil is always present. No matter how much good I seek to do or trying to live right for God, Paul said, evil is always present. And in our story today, David, the servant of God, had to deal with that challenge. David had to deal with King Saul, who kept on offending him. David loved Saul, and David was offended by someone who he cared about. Saul was like a father figure to David. David was loyal to Saul. David had no issues with Saul. David believed that Saul was the anointed one of God. And David thought that Saul was going to be his mentor. You remember that David had been anointed by the prophet Samuel to be the king of Israel. And he thought that Saul would kind of mentor him into his kingship. So David thought that this relationship that he had with Saul was somehow fulfilling the promise of God, and God's promise was unfolding in front of him. But what David didn't understand was that Saul hated him. Saul kept trying to kill David. Saul's purpose was to destroy David. And no matter what David did, he could not please Saul or stop Saul from trying to harm him. Saul just kept on offending David. And no matter what David did, Saul offended him. And one of the things I've learned in life is that when we are offended, we will do one or two things. Either we will seek revenge against those who offended us, or we will remove ourselves from our offender. Look at what David did. David was always on the run from Saul. David ran because Saul was trying to kill him. There are some things, brothers and sisters, you just can't run from. In our story today, David is in a place in his life where he had the opportunity to get revenge on Saul. David could have gotten rid of his problem. David had the opportunity to kill Saul. God was allowing Saul to try to kill David, not for David to be punished, but David didn't understand that though Saul was trying to kill him, God had David's back. And that God wanted David to understand, David, that I'll fight this battle for you. God was using this situation, Kim, to test David's heart. There are times when God has to test our heart. You know, sometimes we can quote the Bible, and we know the Bible. We go to Sunday school. We go to Bible study. We're in prayer meeting. We know the Bible, and we know from Genesis to Revelation. But sometimes God has to test what he's put in you, amen? And sometimes God allows us to be tested and our hearts to be tested. You see, from the world's point of view, David was justified, Linda, into getting revenge against Saul. Even David's servant, Abishai, thought that he should kill Saul. Saul was a bad person. He was wicked. Saul had murdered 85 preachers and their families. Saul, in every way, attempted to kill David. Saul continued to function as king, even though David had been anointed by God to be king. Look at what Saul did. Saul lied on David. Saul sought to turn everybody against David. Saul broke his promise to David. And when you look at the record of all these things Saul did to David, David had every reason to get revenge against Saul. As God was testing David's heart, Satan was baiting David to seek revenge. When we are offended, certain areas are exposed to Satan. When we are being offended, see, there are three things. First of all, your mind is being exposed because Satan will use people to put things in your earlobes and say things to you to cause you to seek revenge. Spiritual warfare is something of the mind. So Satan starts messing with our minds because he wants our minds to be in the wrong place, because what Satan wants is he wants us to get revenge. But not only is he messing with our mind, but he's messing with our emotions. Amen. Because when somebody hurts you, your emotions start to get involved there. So he's messing with David's mind. He's messing with David's emotions. And then as a man, he's messing with David's pride, because another man is confronting him. Another man is trying to hurt him. And brothers, you know when somebody comes at us, we want to go right back at them, because it's an ego thing. It's a pride thing. You try to hurt me, I'm going to hurt you back, because you're dealing with my mind, my emotion, and now you're dealing with my pride.
Yes.
Satan will use things to bait us. He will try to bait us. Maybe he may use a problem with your child to bait you. It might be someone in your family that's hurt you. It might be church hurt, and someone in the church has hurt you. He's trying to bait you. Maybe it's what you heard someone say about you that Satan is trying to bait you. He's telling you that somebody told a lie on you, and he's trying to bait you. Satan took that situation and he tried to bait David. Satan wants us so angry that we act like a Christian. He wants us to judge the offender. Sister Shaw, you go to church every Sunday. You ought to act better because you go to church every Sunday. So then he wants me to judge you because you go to church every Sunday. So he's baiting me to judge you. Then he wants me to rebuke you because you have offended me. Satan will bait us into complaining about the offender. You know, things will be better around here. And Mr. Shaw will be in the choir. It would be better, so we're complaining about Mr. Shaw. Because Mr. Shaw seems to get things started. But y'all know I'm telling the truth in here. He baits us sometimes to violence. He baits us. Have you ever had somebody offend you? And when they offended you, you were so mad that you started avoiding them because they offended you. So when they called you, you wouldn't pick up the phone. Why? Because they offended you. If you go to the same church with them, you make sure you're sitting on the other side of the church. Why? Because they have offended you. So sometimes they're going to speak to you and you give them a boom, you know, because you know you want to say you spoke to them, but you really don't feel good. Why? Because you're mad at them. You want to avoid them.
Amen.
You don't want to speak to them anymore. Why? Because they offended you. But yet you carry this Bible.
My.
And you shout for the Lord.
Come on now.
You sing praises to the Lord. You talk about how good the Lord is and what the Lord has done for you. But you won't even speak to somebody that has offended you. So we hold on to it. Why? Because you offended me.
Yes.
The Bible says, greater is he.
Yes.
Us take control of the spiritual us. And we will let the spiritual us take control of the natural us.
Uh-huh.
Just think about this. How many times in the last 7 days have you offended God? Think about all the things that you have done to God that has offended God. And what if God handled you the same way you handled everybody else that offends you? Well, Pastor, that sounds good, you know. But how do I deal with it? Because, Pastor, I'm human, and somebody has offended me. They have done something. They have said something that has offended me. So how do I handle this, and what does the Bible teach us when it comes to handling people that offend us? I won't hold you long. Let me go over five things real quick. But number one, do not seek revenge. David could have killed Saul. Paul said in Romans 12, do not repay anyone evil for evil. Be careful to do what is right in the eyes of everybody. Amen. Even the person that offended you. If it is possible, as far as it depends on you, not on them, but as far as it depends on them. Be at peace with everybody. Even the person that offended you. Do not take revenge, my friends, but leave room for God's wrath. For it is written, it is mine to revenge. I will repay, says the Lord. On the contrary, if your enemy is hungry, feed him. If he is thirsty, give him something to drink. In doing this, you will heap burning coals on his head. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. Brothers and sisters, we have to leave room for God.
Yes, we do.
Because sometimes you may want God to get somebody, but you have done so much that God might have to get you. Come on now, amen. So sometimes when we get offended, we forget that we have done things to offend other people, but we forget about that when somebody hurts us. So we want God to get them. And listen, let me tell you something. God don't need your help. Because if God's gonna do something to somebody, God's gonna do something. He don't need you helping them. We have a responsibility as Christians to do the right thing. Number two, don't build up walls. Offended people build up walls. And then we find scripture verses where we will get on the internet and we will look up scripture verses that will justify how we feel and what we do to them. Amen. And we'll stay up all night. We'll search all week trying to find the right scripture verse to justify us being evil against somebody else. Amen. You never done ever studied the Bible in your life until somebody offended you. Too. Amen. We'll keep other folk away. Don't y'all mess with family. Because family ain't right. Let me tell you what family did to me. And then what we're doing, see what I'm doing, family, is I'm dropping a seed in their spirit. Because I know they're my friends. So because they're my friends, I'm dropping a seed over there. Because I don't want them to like you because you offended me. So I want them to be mad at you because I'm mad at you. So I'm going to plant a seed over there so that they will be mad at you. Why? Because you offended me. So I'm overcoming evil with evil. I know I got the robe on, but I'm still overcoming evil with evil. Y'all know how we do it. We are less open and vulnerable to others. I'm not going to let you get close to me now because you hurt me. So I'm going to keep my distance. I say I forgave you, but I really didn't forgive you. Because now the relationship has changed. Because you hurt me now, I got a wall up. And I'm only going to let you get so far. I'm going to shake your hand. And I may hug you every now and then, but that's a wall up now. Why? Because you hurt me, amen. So you offended me, Sarah, because you offended me. I got this wall up now. I say I love the Lord and I'm saved and sanctified, but I got this wall. I'm not gonna let you hurt me again. cannot love you unconditionally.
That's right.
Amen. Father, Mary, Paul said in Colossians 3:13, bear with each other and forgive Brother Thomas whatever grievance you may have against one another. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And sometimes we don't do that. We want God to him to forgive us. But we don't want to forgive folk who have offended us. Number three.
Amen.
Determine what kind of tree you're going to be. Jesus said in Matthew 7:18, likewise, every good tree bears good fruit, but a bad tree bears bad fruit. A good tree cannot bear bad fruit, and a bad tree cannot bear good fruit. Thus by their fruit, you will recognize them. Now, if every time I get offended, I get mad, and I go off on you, then that tells you what kind of tree I am. Sister Jesus did, cannot bear bad fruit. So how are you a good tree and you're bearing bad fruit?
Amen.
Come on down.
Sister, how can you be a good tree? And sister, you just so hateful.
My.
You walk in the room and the air goes out of the balloon.
Stop it.
Praise God, because he's just so hateful. Amen. Everybody know, don't mess with you. Don't mess with you. Don't look at you wrong. Because everybody knows what you want to do. Amen. But you sit on the second row in the church. Amen. Come on now, y'all. You know what I'm telling you. Amen. I want to preach this, amen. Number four, focus on yourself.
Yes.
You have the power through Christ to control what you do when you are offended. Jesus said it's not what goes in a man that defiles a man, but what defiles a man or woman comes from their heart. When David messed up with Bathsheba, damn, he didn't blame Bathsheba. He didn't blame the circumstances. Brother, no, he knew that there was something wrong within him. And he knew that if he didn't get himself right, he was going to do it again. So going to church wasn't going to change anything. So David prayed to God. He said, God, created me, oh God, a clean heart. And we knew within me the right spirit. Help me, God, to get over what Michelle did to me. Because I'm going to control how I live and how I behave, not Michelle. So if I'm a good tree, God, then I need you, God, to help me to be a good tree. So no matter what Michelle does, I'm going to be a good tree. Because Michelle doesn't control me. I'm controlled by Christ. Paul said, if anyone be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. There ought to be something different about me if I am in Christ.
Yeah.
Number five. Remember, your struggle is not against the person with offend each other. Paul said in Ephesians 6:12, for our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authority, against the powers of this dark world, and against spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Satan wants you.
Yes, he does.
Satan wants you. Satan wants your soul. He wants your mind. He wants your heart. He wants your spirit. Satan wants you. So that's why he allows people to offend you, because Satan wants you. Kim, it's not about me offending you. He wants you. So he wants you to clap. After, it's not about me offending you. If Satan wants you to clap, why? Because he wants you. He wants your soul. He wants your mind. Sister Thomas, he wants your emotions. So if I push the right button, I can get Mr. Thomas to clap. But I gotta push the right button. Sister Harrison can't get her. Brother Thomas can't get her to act up. But there is somebody in here who can.
Yes.
She don't really care for Lee. So if I can get Lee to say something that offends her, she ain't gonna sit in that seat any longer. If he comes over here and says something to her, she's gonna swell up. Why? Because that's the button to push. And he knows how to push the button. Now, Sister Thomas, she may not say nothing outwardly, but inwardly. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. Inwardly, she's now tore up because what? Lena says something that has offended her. Brothers and sisters, sometimes y'all think y'all got to do something. Sometimes it's not what you do, it's what you don't do that gets you in trouble with God. Because now she's angry in her heart. Now listen, anger doesn't have to come out. The Bible said, don't let the sun go down on your anger. Why? Because you didn't create, Barbara, a stronghold for the devil. Eventually, if it don't come out today, it's coming out. Amen?
Yep, it is.
In time, it's coming out.
Yes.
Keep messing with you. And it's eventually going to do what? It's eventually going to come out. Amen?
Yes.
Here is the last one. Have you ever thought about the fact that God may be using the offender to mature you? Okay, Saul, I'm anointing you king. But listen, I gotta test you. Because you gotta have the right heart and the right spirit to be king. See, God had a purpose for David, but God had to prepare him. God has a purpose for you, but he has to allow you sometimes to be offended.
Yes, yes.
To be tested in order for God to raise you. Paul said in in 1 Corinthians 10:13, no temptation has seized you except what is common to man. Don't you think that you're the only one that's being tempted and being talked about and being offended? Paul said everybody is going through it. Even those people who make me smile, those people got the joy of love, they're being offended too.
Amen, amen. That's right.
But Paul said, God will not let you be tempted beyond what you can bear. God knows, Kenny, how much you can bear. He knows how much to put on you. And when you can't bear it anymore, then you know when God stepped between you and the person. God said, Dad, as I'm taking the punches, I will provide a way out for you so that you can then stand.
Yes.
was offended.
Yes, he was.
Judas betrayed him.
Yes.
Pilate tried to wash his hands of him. Peter denied him.
Yes.
The religious leaders arrested him and beat him.
People
rejected him. They hung him on a cross. He died on a Friday. But because he was faithful to God, God was faithful to him. And if you will be faithful to God, then God will be faithful to you. And the Bible said early on a Sunday morning, it is God's power. So if you want to be a deliverer from being offended, I want to invite you to come to the altar today. And I'm the first one here. God wants you to deliver me from being offended. I don't want to hold any grudges. I don't want to stop speaking to somebody. God wants you to set me free. I've been offended, God, but I need you to restore the joy of my salvation. I've been hurting the child. I've been hurting the church. I've been hurting the home. But God, I need you, God, to deliver me.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.